Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1834. Find rows with matching digits in any sequence. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Gellin. Today, question sent in by a chess move at YouTube. He has random three-digit numbers, for example, 423, and he wants to be able to find all of the numbers that contain those digits in any order. So 432, 324, 342, 234, 243, and so on. Now, this question's been coming in over the course of the last month, and I've been thinking about the best way to do this. And so let's say that we have some numbers over here, and I've just filled it with the numbers 0 to 999. First thing I think that we have to do is do a text function to take that number and make sure that it's really a three-digit number. So I'm using the text of A2 with the 000 format to make sure I'm getting three digits, and then I break that apart into the left. So the left of B2 comma 1, which is going to give me text, of course, so I add 0, and then the mid of B2 starting position 2 for a length of 1, and the right, which will give me the rightmost digit of this three-digit number. Now, it's not really interesting up here at 000, so let's freeze panes, and we'll cruise down here a little bit more. All right, so 184, I'm breaking that 184 into a 1, an 8, and a 4. And then we need, the final result is a column that takes those digits and sorts them into ascending sequence. All right, so we have the 184. I'm looking for the lowest number of the 184. So to do that, let's just focus on this bit right here. I asked for the small of those three numbers, comma 1, which gets me the lowest number. And I want to put that in the 100s place. So that's why I multiply it by 100. And then next, take the small, comma 2, which gets me the second smallest number, which in this case is going to be a 4. Multiply that by 10, and then finally the small comma 3, which gets me the largest number, that is the 8. Okay, so using these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 formulas going across here, I've been able to take the original data and convert it to sorted data. All right, now this is kind of a hassle. I have to use these 5 formulas. So I'm going to go on to the next sheet where we have two formulas. The first formula takes the text of A2 and puts it in that format. And then I've created an array formula, and that array formula is doing the mid of the three-digit number, and it's asking for it to start at the first, second, and third position for a length of 1. Okay, now check this out. When we ask for this, and I press the F9 key, it actually creates an array of the three digits, 5, 7, and 4. Now I multiply those three text digits by 1, to get the actual numbers 574, and then pass that to the small to get the smallest of the three digits, which in this case will give us 4. Multiply that by 100, so we know we have 400. And then again, 574, ask for the second smallest, which will give us the 5. Multiply by 10, so now we have 450. And then the third smallest, which is going to give us the 7. And just add that in, and we will get 457. So it's sorting those three digits, but it's doing it in one formula. Could I modify this formula again to, instead of B575, to put the text of A575? I could do that, and the formula gets even longer, then we wouldn't even need column B here. But I'm going to go back. Right now, you have to press Control Shift Enter here, but I now have something that works. So let's say that we're looking for 423. I have the exact same formula here to convert that 423 to a sorted variety, and then it's just a simple count if. Go look through all of the numbers in C2 to C1000 to see if it's equal to G2. But it struck me that once I have this, once I have all 1000 possibilities already calculated here, why don't I just freeze this, right? Because this is going to be a slow calculation, and over here just build a table. So the original number, here's the sorted version. Again, let's go down to, so 192 converts to 129. And now that I have this table, if we're looking for 423, we're looking for anything where the sorted version is 234. So I'm using an index here. You can use VLOOKUP, whichever you would like, and then a simple count if. All right, so in the course of looking for three-digit numbers that match these digits, to me, and I've been thinking about this for a couple of weeks, it really seems like the best way to go is to build this helper column It takes the original numbers and sorts them, and then whatever I'm looking for, the 423, sort that as well, and try and find everything that matches. Let's just take a look here. So we're looking for 423, that's sorted to 234. So if I would turn on the filter here, and we want to see everything that matches 234. Click OK. All right, so we're getting 234, 243, 324, 342, 423, and 432. Definitely a clunky way to go, but the question keeps coming in week after week after week, and I finally realized I might as well just put it out here on the podcast because this is the best way that I have for doing this. If you have something better, of course, leave it down in the YouTube comments. All right, well, hey, I want to thank ChessMove for sending that question in, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.